All right, so last week I posted a video on YouTube about the Spanish silver mine in Harriman State Park, and a YouTuber actually commented and mentioned that there was a mine at it that was supposed to be possibly a silver mine, but possibly not, somewhere in Dutchess County, east of the rails trails. So I located the only ridge in the area that meets that description. And you could see at the bottom of the ridge, this circular mound. So I marked the beginning, the start of the ridge, the tailings pile, and the end of the ridge. So I'm gonna hike out here, and I'm gonna start at the base of the ridge, following along until I get to the LiDAR anomaly, and we'll see what we can find. There is not supposed to be any sort of silver mine out here. There's no reference to it on MineDat. There's no reference to it on Google Books. The story that the YouTuber was told is that the mine was worked by a prospector and his squaw. So that's a really strange story. It's one that I've heard before with Western mines. So that's all we know about it. It may be silver or it could be something else. But there's the only other mine that I know of in this area that's not an iron mine is the Ankrum lead mine, which is one of the oldest lead mines in the United States. But that mine is now completely gone. That definitely looks like a tailings pile. Oh my god. It is a tunnel. Oh my god. I can't believe this. Oh my god. I can't believe this. Oh my god, an unknown tunnel in Dutchess County? This is like unheard of. Wow, look at the quartz vein. This is incredible. This is unbelievable. Really low.
There's some drill marks, small drill marks. Some of these are pneumatic for sure, and others look like they're hand drills. Drill holes on the floor. Yeah, this is about 50 feet long. Look at the white, all the white. Wow, look at those little drill marks. This is amazing.
All right, so I'm back here on the power lines, and that was an incredible mine. There was a really interesting quartz vein. If I was a prospector, I would have followed that in as well. You could see it right at the mouth of the adit, and about halfway in, you could see it on the floor. I don't know what they were mining, but they were definitely following something. The drill marks were a mixture of small hand-drilled marks and pneumatic. Also, it may have been re-prospected in the late 19th century or even early 20th century, but there's really just no information on it. And that's what makes it so mysterious, is that I never would have found this if it weren't for the tip I received on YouTube. So it just shows that even with really vague tips, using LiDAR, you could just walk out into this backcountry and walk right to a mine tunnel like this. So that was a very successful hike. And I'm really happy to add another mine to my collection of New York State mines, and here is the scan. And it's driven on a much steeper angle than they usually are. You can see how inclined it is. And that was a very exciting day trip out in the hills of Dutchess County. All right, so we're starting to get a little bit of snow here. And I just wanted to relate what I found in the history of Dutchess County. There's really not much on a mine being out here in this particular area. I mean, but the history of this region is full of tales of silver mines. So most of the stories take place in Putnam County, which was once part of Dutchess County. So in the history of Dutchess County, it talks about the history of some of the Putnam County towns. And I mean, there's some really strange stories. In the town of Southeast, there were two men who thought that they had found a silver mine on Joe's Hill, which is actually really close to the Danbury border, to the Connecticut border. And they went up there to mine and were living up there with these strange men called pigeon men. I'm not sure what pigeon men are. And they were using necromancy, and they were manipulating the occult to find silver, and just really strange stories. One of the two men who supposedly found the silver mine, when he was on his deathbed, his brother asked him, is there really a silver mine up there? Have you really found a silver mine? And he was unable to speak, but his brother said, squeeze my hand if there is a silver mine up on Joe's Hill. And he squeezed his hand tightly. So deathbed confession that there was a silver mine up there. I'm actually going to go look for that one next after this, because I do have some LiDAR anomalies, and I do have an 1800s map that shows a mine on Joe's Hill in that area. I mean, there's stories not about mines, but, you know, Spanish silver doubloons were found actually on a hill just to the east of here. A widow found a doubloon on the ground when she was hiking over this mountain, and then her son went back and found one, and then a treasure hunting party was sent up there, and 16 doubloons were found in total. That's pretty interesting. Down in Phillipstown in 1763, there was a man who found a silver mine, and he was actually making his own coins, and which was highly illegal, from the silver, and he was caught in 1765 and hung over in Poughkeepsie. There was a man named Gray who was mining silver over on the Sunk Lot, which is a tract of like 1,300 acres of land, which is now in Clarence Van Stock State Park. And he had built a log cabin there, and he was mining silver and built a workshop. But this was a few years before the Revolutionary War, and his mine was said to have just disappeared. So there's some interesting stories out there. I mean, I know during the time of the Phillipses, before the Revolution, I know that there were silver mine operations, and they were being paid royalties. So it's not that there aren't silver mines out here. There's lots of stories, and there's just no concrete proof that silver was ever mined in these hills anywhere in Dutchess County or Putnam County.